Hey everybody, it's Dr. Matthew Herdert here again, founder of ThrivingDiabetics.com and the Freedom from Diabetes programs. And I had a really weird day today. I don't know what was going on, but I feel like a very high percentage of the people who I dealt with today were really interested in casting blame around. Luckily, gratefully, not at me. Really, it was stuff that didn't have anything to do with me except that I was dealing with and interacting with the people who are kind of in this mode, and they didn't even have anything to do with each other. It was sort of a random procession of people coming through my day who were really focused on people having messed up and screwed things up and how at fault they were and how bad they were for having done that. And it was enough that it got my attention. And I'm like, okay, apparently I'm supposed to be thinking about this today or sharing about this or something. And the thing to me, even though I understand that this is either in human nature or so deeply woven into the culture of America, which is where I've grown up, that I feel like it's part of human nature. I think we owe it to ourselves and to the world to try and step out of and beyond kind of our current state of limitation. So even if it is human nature, that's fine. But I think it's our responsibility to try and evolve out of that, right? You know, whatever that limitation is. And the thing to me about guilt and about blame is it is never, ever, ever productive. It's never productive. It keeps you grounded in negativity and in powerlessness. So there's a big difference between blame or, you know, feeling guilt or throwing blame at somebody or playing the blame game and looking into a situation that went askew and trying to figure out what happened and how to fix it or course correct or make it better next time. Those are two totally different things. You know, when something goes wrong, it's often your responsibility in a management position or really, I think, any level that you're involved in a situation or a circumstance, it's your part of your responsibility to that situation to try and figure out how to make things better the next time, especially if something went horribly wrong. But sitting down with somebody and saying, I'm aware that this went wrong, what can we do next time to keep this on course? Or how can we avoid this mistake next time? Or how can I support you in avoiding this in the future? There's a big difference between that, which is really course corrective and neutral emotionally, right? You're not getting involved in the anger or the upset or the resentment that fuels that blame. There's a big difference between that and saying to that person, well, you totally messed this up and how dare you, or, you know, taking out your upset on that person, or even worse, arguably going around to everybody else in the situation, in the company or the organization, the institution, and saying, yeah, you know, Joe messed that up, or boy, Mary really blew it again. I mean, it really kind of undermines the entire structure of a team, whether it's a family, whether it's a set of medical practitioners you're involved in. I work very hard in my practice never to say negative things about other practitioners in town. So if somebody's looking for a referral in a specific area, I'll say, well, you know, I would go, if I were you, I would recommend this person or this person, and these are the reasons why. And if they bring up the name of somebody I would not recommend for them, I'll say, I don't think that person would be a good fit for you. And then if they ask why, you know, I'll try and find a way to talk about whatever I see as being, you know, a drawback of that practitioner. And if I've heard 50 lousy things and one nice thing about that doc, I'm not going to phrase it that way, you know. I just don't think it's useful. I don't think it's productive. And I don't think it helps make anything better for anybody. So if you're involved in a situation like that, look at how you can get out of the negativity, which is very easy to get into. It's not like I never get into that space. Don't get me wrong. I'm not superhuman. You know, I'm not some spiritual guru. I'm not the Buddha. You know, I'm not in that space with stuff. But I always want to try and have a positive emotional experience. And I want to be as effective as I can be, you know, mentally and in terms of my involvement in situations. So a little bit of rambling there, but it was just interesting today how many people I ran across who were in that space. And so I'm holding for them that they're able to get over that on this weekend. It's a beautiful Friday sunset. I'm sure you can see the sunlight. Well, I guess it's kind of gone now, but sorry for the traffic noise, the church noise. Hopefully it's added interesting extra flavor to the video. And again, the encouragement, the challenge for you guys is if you're involved in any situations like that in your family, in your extended family, especially if it's with your healthcare team, if it's in the workplace, look to see how you can get out of that negative space and into the productivity of forward movement, of correcting course versus trying to make people wrong for the mistakes they've made. So Hope you guys are doing well wherever you are in the world today, deeply and lovingly and enthusiastically engaged in the things that bring you juice. I encourage you to go out there this weekend and live large, grab a hold of the things that turn you on, be well, and thrive.